Dia Guith, my name is Sinead and I work here in Roth House and Garden in Kilkenny. Roth House is a 17th century merchant's townhouse complete with restored medieval / Renaissance gardens, and we are Kilkenny's hidden gem. I'm here to tell you about a quirky story that happened to me some years ago while I was working on reception. It was a Friday evening, it was 7:15, I just wanted to go home. And I was packing up and I heard a little knock at the door. I answered it. This elderly gentleman asked if I could assist him. And I said, okay, sure, come on in. Now, we do genealogy services here in Roth House. So I was presuming it was to do with that. And he went on to tell me that his name was John and he was from the States and that he was looking for a particular church, a graveyard, actually. And that if I could assist him with that, I said, sure. OK, well, what's the name of the graveyard? And he said, I don't know. I said, OK, well, do you know what location it's in? And he said, I don't. And I said, okay, well, really, without a name or location, I can't really help you. As we all know, there's quite a lot of churches and graveyards in Ireland. So, you know, it's a needle in a haystack situation. So he thanked me for my time and he went to leave. But something just told me to call him back. So I did. And I said, look, We'll figure this out. So I went on the googly woogly and I started googling churches and graveyards in County Kilkenny. And I said, you know, where were you going when you discovered this? And he said, well, we were traveling from Thomastown to Waterford. We went off the beaten track and we just discovered this beautiful graveyard. So I said, okay, Thomastown to Waterford. After a lot of searching, I decided that I thought I knew where he was talking about. I said, I think it's Stone Carty Graveyard is where you're talking about. I'm a local in that area. It sounds to me, he had drawn a diagram of the graveyard complete with cows in the field around it. So I was like, I recognise those cows because I used to go up to their graveyard when I was a youngster. And so I said, I think that's it. Now, he was staying in Knocktopher Abbey, fabulous location. So he was only a few minutes away. So I organised with him for the next day that we would go up to Stone Carty. The reason being was he explained to me that Friday evening that him and his wife honeymooned in Ireland in 1964. And they had found this beautiful graveyard and they had lunch there. And she said, you know, John, this is so beautiful. Her family were English and Irish. And she said, when I die, take some of my ashes and scatter them here. And this gentleman was in his late 80s and she had passed away 3 years previous to that. So he said it was his last journey ever. And it was going to be to Ireland to do exactly that, to find this graveyard. But he also went on to tell me that he had a brain like a sieve, a very bad memory, and that this was something him and his wife would constantly over the years she would make fun of him for. So he said, I'm really proud of myself that I remembered to do this one thing that my wife really, really wanted. So I was really taken aback by this beautiful act of love. So we organized and we went up to Stone Carty the next day. And he said, I don't think this is the church. And I was like, oh, no. But he said, you know, I'm here now. I'm going home tomorrow. And it's something that I wanted to do. And I'm sure my wife would understand that after 70 years, I can't remember where the church was. So he then asked me, I had said to him, you know, would you like me to say a prayer? And he said, you know, I would love an Irish Colleen to sing Danny Boy. It was my wife's favorite song. And I was like, oh, good Lord, I have not got a note in my head, but I didn't want to disappoint him. So I said, okay. So I started off the chorus. So Danny Boy, the pipes. And John started talking to his wife saying, Caroline, we thank you for so many beautiful years of marriage. Thank you for all our wonderful kids who give us all our wonderful grandchildren that you love so much. And I was still kind of standing to the side, still singing, you know, the summer's gone and all the flowers are dying. And he just tipped over the ashes after some time and they just went into the light breeze and that was it. And then I continued singing Danny Boy and he looked over at me and he just burst out laughing, completely just big hearty belly laughs and just tears rolling down his face. And I just looked at him and I said, my singing's hardly that bad, is it? And in between the laughter and the crying, he said, no, dear, no, it's not your singing. He said, I just remembered we honeymooned in England. I'm in the wrong country. And I literally died on the spot with the laughter. The two of us, we just went into the hysterics and we went off for a pint afterwards. And I just thought it was the funniest experience that I've ever had to do with work in my life. And it was just amazing. And he said to me that it was his last trip. And I said, are you going to go to England? And he said, well, I can't really bring the ashes over now. That's my little quirky story from working in Roth House and Garden, and I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for listening.